EG.5 is the predominant variant in the United States now. All of these variants that we are dealing with currently are all Omicron-based variants, and so they're all slightly different. They all have some mutations which enhance their ability to be transmitted from person to person and may also allow them to escape some of the prior immunity. BA.286 was recently identified in small numbers outside the United States, and there were concerns that because it had so many mutations in it, that it was going to run wild and there would be no way for our immune system to contain it, whether we'd been vaccinated or have had COVID before or both. But it turns out that it's not so virulent and it probably isn't quite as effective as escaping. Since Omicron became the predominant variant in the United States, one of the Omicron variants, what we've seen is that the number of cases go up and down, but the severity of the cases generally are not so severe. The face of COVID-19 in 2023 is very different than what we saw in March and through December of 2020, where people were on ventilators and we were seeing high rates of death. We still see mortality, and I think that COVID-19, the importance of COVID-19 is that there's still so darn many number of cases, right? So even if the mortality rate is tiny, because the number of cases are so high, it still becomes a significant number and still probably will end up being the leading respiratory cause of death, not necessarily the leading cause of death as it was previously. I think it should be managed similar to flu and RSV. Everybody's sort of lumping the three together. I think that's probably a fair way to look at it. Once a significant number of people get infected and a number of people are vaccinated, it'll probably taper down a little bit. But I don't think we're ever going to get to a point where we're starting to worry about beds in hospitals and having enough ventilators and having all this other going on. But I think it's going to be a respiratory viral season and maybe starting to be a little bit more normal because people aren't masking routinely and some of the other behaviors that sort of modified the respiratory viral seasons in the past couple of years probably are not going to be as strongly at play. And so I suspect we're going to see peaks in the winter like we would normally expect to see with respiratory viruses. Masks work. I know that there have been some what are called meta-analyses that have looked at this, that have debated benefits. But when you really look at the data, and some of the studies in the meta-analysis are from years ago, when you really look at the data, it does decrease risks. We've seen it in our hospital settings. We've seen it in the community. And so, again, I don't think as we stand outdoors here, that we need to be masked, but if we're in a crowded area and we're concerned and there's a lot of virus circulating within the population and you're high risk, put on a mask. A KN95, they're easy to find now. I think they work, and if it doesn't bother you to wear them, that's good.